Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
This morning, let us reflect on our Old Testament reading, Micha chapter 5, verses 2 and 5, just for a moment. Please sit back and relax, and let us enjoy listening to the word of the Lord just for a moment. How many of you have experiences of uncertainty? Probably no one. Oh, okay, she is uncertain. Where did you do that? Pardon? Oh, no. Okay. Yeah, because we are not from California or Hawaii, we are not surfers. But actually, there are some Canadian surfers too. If you go to Tofino, you will see surfers there. And also at the Great Lakes in Ontario, and certain parts of the Great Lakes, you will see strong community of surfers there too. But except those places, you know, it is impossible to find places for surfing here. Especially California and Hawaii are usually the meccas of surfing. If you go to Hawaii, especially the north shore of Hawaii, it's just tremendous for surfing. But don't try surfing there because the waves are extremely big. Especially in the winter time, the waves are over 10 meters high. It's just monstrous waves. Just imagine the waves that is even higher, probably slightly higher than our church building, from the ground to the top of our church building. Can you imagine that? You know, sliding down on that wave requires extreme skill and also extremely dangerous. But in Hawaii and North Shore, every year, there is the Vans Triple Crown of Surfing, which is considered the Super Bowl of surfing, is held on at the shores every year. And as you see on the screen, every year when they do surfing, just the waves are like that. It's huge, monstrous waves, which is over 10 meters high, up to 12, 13 meters high. Extremely big and huge, and only the world top class surfers can ride those waves. And then, often, some are killed by those waves. But I guess some of you have experiences of visiting Hawaii for your summer vacation. But if you go to different beautiful beaches, then it's a whole different story. We don't see those huge waves at those beaches, and just the beaches look like that. So beautiful, gorgeous, and the water is usually very calm and so relaxing. So that Hawaii attracts so many tourists every year and all year round. But once again, if you go to the North Shore of Hawaii, it's a different story. The water is so different. It's like just a roaring monster. Waves are huge and monstrous. And then when you come here, the water is so calm. Actually, our life and this world are just like Hawaii. Quite often, we have huge storms and huge waves in our lives. And after we pass through all those things, and our lives become just like a beautiful water in Hawaii. And then the waves come again, and storms come again. And we have to go through those again, and then we taste the peace again. If we fail to go through those storms and waves in our lives, then we lose our life. So that's why our life here is, regardless of our social status, the amount of our possession, not easy at all. It's quite tough and challenging. And also, this world is not a really peaceful place. When you look at the human history is just full of wars, killing each other, and massacres, and all kinds of things. And just let's take a look at this year, 2015. Wars, battles, and conflicts are still going on and on all over, especially in Syria, Israel, Afghanistan, Iraq, and also ISIS and so on. And recently, we observed terror in Paris, France, and that terror killed so many people. And also, terrors are happening all over. And also, just a while ago, a Russian airliner were crashed in Egypt, and Malaysian airliner was also crashed, shut down in Ukraine. And all the passengers and all the crew were killed in those accidents. Actually, that is not accident, it's terrorism. And just within 2015, this year, according to the statistics, there have been at least 24 big aviation accidents. And economists are predicting US dollars collapse and huge economic crisis. Hopefully it doesn't happen. And also many people are predicting a third world war. And our society is getting more and more anti-Christian society. People are leaving the churches and the Lord, and also people are getting rude and selfish, so that very aggressive and rude drivers are all over. And the prices are going up, the amount of the payment of the bills are going up, our finances are tight, our body is aging and suffering from issues and troubles, so that the numbers of the bottles of medication that we take are increasing. Job security or business security is not guaranteed. We get hurt or struggle with relationship issues with some people around us. Our lives and this world are just like Northern Hawaii. There is no peace and no long-lasting calmness in this world and in this life here. The Old Testament reading this morning is the prophetic words of Micha for Savior's coming as the Prince of Peace. Our Savior Jesus Christ is the Prince of Peace. At his birth, the angels said, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth to men of good will." His constant admonition was, "Fear not, do not worry, don't be afraid, it is I. Go in peace, your sins are forgiven. Blessed are the peacemakers." When he sent his disciples out to preach the gospel, he told them, "When you enter a house, peace be to this house." You have to say, "Peace be to house." In his last discourse, he told his disciples, "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you." After he had risen from the dead, his constant greeting to his disciples was, "Peace be with you." Peace. Peace is one of the most important things in our life, and also peace was one of the most important things of our Savior, Jesus Christ. To give that peace, he came. But peace, where is this peace? It is not found in this world and in this life here. And sadly, this world will never be totally peaceful. It is not to be found in the absence of violence, terrorism, and war. If you are waiting for peace in this world, actually we have wrong expectation. Human nature and man's proven capacity for evil, it is not a bright prospect. Peace is not found in other people either. Yet, how often do our peace depend on the mind and the lips of other people, or on what they think or say about us? Peace is not to be found in myself either. I see a law in my body warning against the law in my mind. The good I will, I do not. The evil I will not, I do. Romans chapter 7, St. Paul says that. When I look at myself, I get discouraged. I realize that I do not have it all together. My experience tells me that I'm a bundle of contradictions. The total and the perfect peace of Christ is not to be found in this world or in the people around us or in yourself or myself. It is not the result of human effort. Peace is a wonderful gift of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ has only true power for bringing that perfect peace to us, for that he came as the babe born in the manger in Bethlehem, and he constantly comes to you and to me physically through the blessed sacrament of Holy Communion. Even though we often face a storm and big waves in our lives, we find the peace and hope in Christ, because he is our shelter, and he calms down that storm and waves, and we receive that peace from Jesus Christ through his holy word, sacrament, and prayer, which are the channels of his grace. So let us come to our Savior Jesus faithfully through prayers, through his holy word and sacraments, so that he may continue to work in your daily life, in my daily life, and also in our church and in this community, that we have peace in your job, in your business, in your home, in your family, in your heart, in your body, in your soul, in our church, in our community. And our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ will grant us peace through his holy word and sacrament and prayer on our face. May the Lord grant you peace. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ came for peace for us, and he shall be our peace. Amen. May the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in Jesus Christ, our Savior, both now and forever.